I speak with a mask?
No, please, mask down.
Huh?
You can put the mask down. I think we have the necessary distance, so I can hold it for you.
No, better is just for the paper.
Okay.
Good morning. At the Foreign Affairs Council today, we have three main points for our discussion. As you can imagine, Belarus is very high in the agenda, but also Libya, and our relationship with the African Union, with Africa in general. On Belarus, I have to regret that the situation continues to deteriorate with ongoing repression against peaceful protesters, as everybody can see on the images on TV. I am very much impressed by that. Today we will discuss about how to support the Belarusian population and how to review our relationship with the Belarus government according with the situation where we don't recognize Lukashenko as the legitimate president of Belarus. I am happy that we could meet with Svetlana Tikhanovskaya on the hours before the council. The members had the opportunity to meet her, and she gave us her account of the events in Belarus. We are really impressed by the courage and perseverance of the Belarusian people, especially Belarusian women, who show a real sense of leadership. Let me stress that we will support inclusive national dialogue on the rights of the Belarusian people for free and fair elections. And this cannot be regarded as an interference in internal affairs, because democracy and human rights are at the core of the identity of the European Union. On Libya, after many months, I see a reason for cautious optimism. There is a positive momentum, there is a ceasefire, and we need to use it. We'll talk about that. I will debrief the Council about my visit to Libya and my reaching out with the Egyptian government also about Libya and how can we support the peace efforts. There are some concrete decisions regarding our sanctions list, but I will talk about it in our afternoon press conference. We'll talk about our relationship with Africa. You know that the summit with Africa has been delayed due to the coronavirus effects, but we will continue working on reaching out with our African partners in order to face the new challenges, such as to fight against the pandemics and the economic recovery. And we have many other current affairs. I will talk about Venezuela, debriefing my colleagues about the International Crisis Group meeting and my conversations during the summer, both with the government and the opposition. And during the lunch, we will pay a lot of attention to our southern neighborhood. As you see, there is a very busy and interesting agenda. We'll talk about the results of the discussions in the Council later in the afternoon. Thank you.
Thanks.
Come here.